Hey guys, Jibber here. Oh. Welcome back to Portal 2.
Just informed me that I should not have mentioned the control group. They're telling me I ought to stop making these pre-recorded messages. That gave me an idea. Make more pre-recorded messages. I pay the bills here. I can talk about the control group all damn day. This next test, we put nanoparticles in the gel. In layman's terms, that's a billion little gizmos that are going to travel into your bloodstream and pump experimental genes and RNA molecules and so forth into your tumors. Now, maybe you don't have any tumors. Well, don't worry. If you sat on a folding chair in the lobby and weren't wearing lead underpants, we took care of that too. In case you got covered in that repulsion gel, here's some advice the lab boys gave me. Do not get covered in the repulsion gel. We haven't entirely nailed down what element it is yet, but I'll tell you this, it's a lively one, and it does not like the human skeleton.
Okay. Not reassuring, but thank you, Cave Johnson, right? It was Cave Johnson, I think. Hmm.
All these science spheres are made of asbestos, by the way. Keeps out the rats. Let us know if you feel a shortness of breath, a persistent dry cough, or your heart stopping. Because that's not part of the test. That's asbestos. Good news is, the lab boys say the symptoms of asbestos poisoning show a median latency of 44.6 years. So if you're 30 or older, you're laughing. Worst case scenario, you miss out on a few rounds of Canasta. Plus, you forwarded the cause of science by 3 centuries. I punch those numbers into my calculator, it makes a happy face.
Yeah, no, I figured. Where to next? Was it? There we go. Toughy. Wait. Aha. Found it. Okay then. Now what? No, can't do anything with that. Those full glass windows? Can I get them from over here? I can.
I like your style. You make up your own rules, just like me. Bean Counter said I couldn't fire a man just for being in a wheelchair. Did it anyway. Ramps are expensive.
Oh, really? Yeah!
Had fluorescent calcium in it so we can track the neuronal activity in your brain. There's a slight chance the calcium could harden and vitrify your frontal lobe. Anyway, don't stress yourself thinking about it. I'm serious. Visualizing the scenario while under stress actually triggers the reaction.
Ah, good to know. I still can't believe I'm playing a game with a character voiced by J.K. Simmons.
Now, if you're part of control group Kepler-7, we implanted a tiny microchip about the size of a postcard into your skull. Most likely you've forgotten it's even there. But if it starts vibrating and beeping during this next test, let us know. because that means it's about to hit 500 degrees, so we're going to need to go ahead and get that out of you pretty fast.
Oh, right, right, right. Ah! Okay. No, 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 I know. Perfect.
Telling them, keep your pants on. All right, this next test may involve trace amounts of time travel. So, word of advice, if you meet yourself on the testing track, don't make eye contact. Lab boys tell me that'll wipe out time. Entirely. Forward and backward. So, do both of yourselves a favor.
Oh, God!
Just let that handsome devil go about his business.
Okay.
All right, this next test may involve trace amounts of time travel. So, word of advice, if you meet yourself on the testing track, don't make eye contact. Lab boys tell me that'll wipe out time. Entirely. Forward and backward. So, do both of yourselves a favor and just let that handsome devil go about his business.
I did it again. You know what? I deserve that. I have to find a way to balance myself at great speed.
All right, this next test may involve trace amounts of time travel. So, word of advice, if you meet yourself on the testing track, don't make eye contact. Lab boys tell me that'll wipe out time. Entirely. Forward and backward. So, do both of yourselves a favor and just let that handsome devil go about his business.
Okay. These are clever tests. All right then. Looks like I'm done here. Here, that is. I don't even know what I'm doing, honestly. Orange. Blue. Orange. Blue. Fuck. Could have just done this. I'll figure this out. For sure. Right then, move them back here. Now what? I need a way to bounce off. In business, baby. Let's do this. Woo! Nice. Okay. Well.
If you're hearing this, it means you're taking a long time on the catwalk between tests. The lab boys say that might be a fear reaction. I'm no psychiatrist, but coming from a bunch of eggheads who wouldn't recognize the thrill of danger if it walked up and snapped their little pink bras, that sounds like projection. They didn't fly into space, storm a beach, or bring back the gold. No, sir, we did. It's you and me against the world, son. I like your grit. Hustle could use some work, though. Now let's solve this thing.
Okay, what next? I really don't know what I'm doing. Oh, right, that lowers the elevator. Honestly. God. No! Please. God damn. Where is it? This extreme physics object. No! Come back. Yes, this way. God damn it! Oh, is it? Oh. I could have picked it up this entire time. Okay, now it's not bouncing. But even better. Right there then. Nah.
Science isn't about why, it's about why not. Why is so much of our science dangerous? Why not marry safe science if you love it so much? In fact, why not invent a special safety door that won't hit you on the butt on the way out because you are fired? Now you test subject, you're doing fine. Yes, you, box your stuff, out the front door, parking lot, car, goodbye.
You know, this Cave Johnson guy, I don't know. Seems pretty cool to me. Alright. Very happy to be playing Portal 2.
Congratulations! The simple fact that you're standing here listening to me means you've made a glorious contribution to science. As founder and CEO of Aperture Science, I thank you for your participation and hope we can count on you for another round of tests. We're not going to release this stuff into the wild until it's good and damn ready, so as long as you keep yourself in top physical form, there will always be a limo waiting for you. Say goodbye, Carolyn.
Goodbye, Carolyn.
She is a gem.
Elevator to surface is boarded up, so... but
Greetings, friend. I'm Cave Johnson, CEO of Aperture Science. You might know us as a vital participant in the 1968 Senate hearings on missing astronauts. And you've most likely used one of the many products we invented, but that other people have somehow managed to steal from us. Black Mesa can eat my bankrupt...
Sir, the testing?
Right. Now you might be asking yourself, Cave, just how difficult are these tests? What was in that phone book of a contract I signed? Am I in danger? Let me answer those questions with a question. Who wants to make $60? Cash. You can also feel free to relax for up to 20 minutes in the waiting room, which is a damn sight more comfortable than the park benches most of you were sleeping on when we found you. So, welcome to Aperture. You're here because we want the best, and you're it. Nope. Couldn't keep a straight face. Anyway, don't smudge up the glass down there. In fact, why don't you just go ahead and not touch anything unless it's test-related.
You know what? He sounds kind of familiar. Fuck. Am I doing something wrong here? Just have to back up. The reunion.
Did anything happen while I was out?
The testing area is just up ahead. The quicker you get through, the quicker you'll get your $60. Carolyn, are the compensation vouchers ready?
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson. Why did I just... Who is that? What the hell is going on here?
Thank you. Alright then. Also do that next time, because that's about it for today. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!